It's dark outside, but it's light in here. Hanukkah, Hanukkah is here.
Freilich in Hanukkah, Talmidei Shalavim. The Gemara Maseches Shabbos, Daf Chaf Aleph Amud Beis asks, My Hanukkah, what is Hanukkah? Why do we light candles for 8 days? The Gemara answers, Shenichnasu Yevanim Leheichal, Timo Kol Hashmonim Shebeheichal. The Yevanim entered the Beis HaMikdash and defiled all of the oil that was there. Shegavru Malchus Beis Chashmonayim V'Nitzchum. When eventually the Chashmonayim were victorious over the Yevanim, Bodku V'lo Matzu Alapach Echad Shal Sheman Shaymunach B'chosmo Shal Kohen Gadol. The Chashmonayim went and searched throughout the Beis HaMikdash, but were only able to find one jar of oil that still had the signature of the Kohen Gadol. Only one jar of oil that was still B'kedusha V'tara. V'lo Hayabo L'Hadlik Yom Echad. This oil should only have lasted 1 day. Nase Bones Hedliku Meno Shmona Yom. A miracle occurred, and this one jar of oil lasted for 8 days. The Beis Yosef, the beginning of Hilchas Chanukah, asks, why is Chanukah an 8-day celebration? Which is, in fact, the Gemara's question. This answer doesn't seem to answer it. After all, there was enough oil in that one jar for one night. Then the miracle was only for 7. We should only have Chanukah for 7 days. So the Beis Yosef gives 2 answers. The first is that the Kohanim divided the oil into 8ths. Enough for every night. And what they discovered was that little bit of oil miraculously lasted the whole night. That's one interpretation. The second one is they poured all the oil in, risking giving it all up, and that oil in the morning was still there. It burnt the whole night, but was still there in the morning. So the miracle, according to the first interpretation, is that the little bit of oil lasted longer than it should have. And the other answer, the second answer, is that when they poured all the oil in, miraculously there was enough, there was more the next day. Perhaps these are actually two, you could think about this as 2 approaches in Avodas Hashem, when our storehouses of oil are depleted. You know, when we're in yeshiva, our storehouses are full of oil, so to say, in Ruchnius. We feel overwhelmed by the opportunities in Ruchnius. But other times in our lives, you might feel like you don't have so much to give. So Beis Yosef gives us 2 etzas. One is, divide it up and just do a little. And you know what? A nace might occur that you have more to give or more to offer than you thought. That little bit will last longer. Or another approach is, give it everything you have. Throw everything you have into it, and you know what? You'll have more to give the next day. You won't be burnt out. You won't be all depleted. I hope that these 2 approaches in Yiddishkeit, when you go out into the world, will be used. The first one being, always make sure to give a little, because it'll help you go further than you thought. And sometimes it's important to give everything you have, and that you won't get burnt out and you'll have more. I wish you all a Chanukah Sameach and a Freilich in Chanukah. May we all continue to grow in Avodas Hashem.
Chanukah, Chanukah is here, and Neda is Allah.